This is the Radiomaster Pocket. It's an FPV controller that's the latest from Radiomaster with a surprisingly competitive $65 price tag. I've had it for a couple of weeks and done about 100 flights with it, and it's a very impressive radio, but it's not without its quirks, and we'll get into those in a little bit. Let's crack this thing open. The first thing that hits you is the build quality. Radiomaster has been known for quality, and the Pocket doesn't disappoint. You're getting impressive bang for buck. It's a solid device and definitely outperforms the price point. The Pocket adopts this hybrid gamepad box style form factor. Where you'd usually find the empty space in the middle of the gamepad, Radiomaster has enclosed that area to house the mainboard. A clever design choice. It allows the Pocket to use two 18650 batteries, effectively solving the biggest issue with the Zorro, battery life. It's clear that this is being targeted as a travel radio or as a budget entry-level device. But despite the compact form factor, don't assume you'll have to trade it in once you decide to level up. This could serve as a great companion even after you've upgraded to something like the Boxer or the TX16S. So let's take a look at its ergonomics. The Pocket seems to favour thumb grip users. Switches and buttons fall right under your fingers naturally. But for hybrid or pinch grip pilots, you might find your fingers rubbing on the radio due to the stick height. And the switches button placement isn't as intuitive as it would be like on a larger radio, such as the Boxer or the TX12. The gimbals and sticks are interesting though. The stick ends are removable and can be stored at the back of the radio. However, they're M3 sized. So you'll need an adapter to fit any of the longer stick ends that you can buy for the DJI FPV remote too. The gimbals on the Pocket are smaller than the mini gimbals you'd find on other gamepad style radios, even the Zorro or the TX12, and they're aptly named Pocket Gimbals. But if you were to keep with the typical naming styles in FPV, they really should be called Nano Gimbals. Initially, the shorter travel distance of these Pocket or Nano Gimbals can be a little bit challenging to get used to. It took me several flights to just find familiarity. But then I found myself having to lower my rates in order to compensate for their size. I do wish they went with mini gimbals, but this isn't necessarily a deal breaker, especially if you plan on using this as a travel radio or if it's your first radio. Now, if you're thinking what I'm thinking, the Pocket does have a lot of similarities with the DJI FPV remote too. And you're not wrong. It seems today the trend from FPV companies is to steal like an artist from DJI. From the mirrored button and switch layout to the foldable antenna and the nano gimbals, there's clear inspiration here. Now, in terms of the buttons and switches, I do appreciate the latching SA and SD switches, and there's also a visual indicator with LED lights. Now, this isn't exactly a game changer when the goggles are on, but quite useful when setting up as it helps you avoid accidents. The Pocket does come in two versions, the CC2500 for FreeSky and the ExpressLRS version. Both feature a nano module bay for adding Crossfire, Tracer, Ghost, or an even more powerful ExpressLRS module. And you can even add Radiomaster's 4-in-1 module as well. My recommendation, go with the ExpressLRS version. And in the event that you'd think you'd want to fly FreeSky or any of the other RC plane radio links, which is kind of pointless for FPV in 2023 anyway, then you can grab the external 4-in-1 module and start transitioning the rest of your gear to ExpressLRS. The ExpressLRS version shares the same internal module as the Zorro, and that gives you up to 250 milliwatts of output power. And you might be thinking, well, it's not 1 watt, but trust me, 250 milliwatts with ExpressLRS is good for up to 30 kilometers. Plus, it has full ELRS support, unlike some of the other budget radios on the market. Beta FPV jumper. Sorry, my unit came with ExpressLRS V3 right out of the box. And that meant I didn't even have to flash it. To bind, you can simply just enable the Wi-Fi hotspot, go to the access point page, and then enter your binding phrase, and you're done. Now to pivot a little bit, Radiomaster's been getting into customization, and you can personalize your Radiomaster Pocket with different colored shells, which is a nice touch for those wanting to make this device truly their own. There's no word on Nano AG01 gimbals either, which is why I think it's a missed opportunity to go with these Nano instead of mini gimbals. So after getting to know the Radiomaster Pocket for the last couple of weeks, I've got to say it's a pretty solid package. It's a perfect second radio radio or for someone that does a lot of travel. And if you're thinking about getting it as a budget radio because you're just getting started, even though I'm a believer in buy once, cry once, I can't deny that the value that this radio offers. So if you did want to buy an entry-level radio and then upgrade later, then this is the perfect first FPV radio. Sure, it does have its quirks for the price and versatility, but it's a real contender. The Radiomaster Pocket is a quality build with a fair price, and it is filled with a lot of potential. If you've been in FPV for a little while and you've never built a drone, it can be really daunting. So I'd recommend you check out the link in the description, which is my course called Build Masterclass, where I go through all the detail that you need to know about how to build a drone. But if you're not ready to take on a build, or if you already know how, watch this video here for 7 tips that every FPV pilot should know. I'm Darren Allett. Until next time, don't forget to send it.